Okay. Thank you all very much. Hi, this is Nicholas van der Wolf from Astute Graphics. This is an impromptu second roundup from the session we did last week covering uniform strokes in Adobe Illustrator. And within Adobe Illustrator, we were drawing maps and automatically putting black outlines around the strokes on the maps. Very useful feature. In fact, we've had probably the highest feedback and trial rate from any webinar we've done, and that's in previous years, which is astonishing. It was only meant as quite a quick impromptu get into the scene off doing these live webinars on YouTube. So, in this second one, what I'm going to do is demonstrate how we can actually cater for varying thicknesses of stroke. I will demonstrate this. On the screen you have in front of you, you will see that the blue or the highways, the motorways, the blue lines, are thicker than the green lines on this map, and are thicker again than the white lines. So the white lines are the smallest country lanes, the green lines are sort of the middle roads, they're a little bit thicker, and then the blue ones are the thicker still lines on the outside. Now, what we had in the previous week's webinar, if we look at the previous week's file, we didn't have white roads, the small country lanes. We only had the two large roads, and by coincidence, I kept them the same width, which in reality you wouldn't really do. I'll demonstrate this. Normally you'd say a motorway is a bit of a thicker stroke than the green roads. So first of all, because I'm on a different setup here and I've gone back to the essentials one, I would like to see the top control bar there. Now this is turned off in CC 2018 by default. It was introduced in CCS6 earlier, I think, or the early CC versions, and this is lovely context sensitive control bar at the top. I've got so used to it. Now they have turned it off in CC 2018 because they introduced a properties panel, which is a great thing as well. But in reality, I like working with both. Because this is a slightly smaller screen for recording, I'm actually closing off the properties panel a bit, and I'm going to rely on the control bar at the top. So with the motorway selected, I'm going to make sure that it's a slightly thicker stroke like that. And with the green road selected, I'm going to make sure it's a slightly thinner stroke. And by doing that, and I'm going to turn off the other markers on top here to make it a bit clearer. By doing that, you'll be able to see that because of the technique we used last week, we applied a stroke in the background, that stroke was a uniform thickness. So it didn't take into account the thickness of the underlying stroke on which you're basing it. So in this case, it looks a bit odd. The black outline around the green stroke is just too heavy. And the black outline around the blue stroke, well, it looks fine, but it's not really compensating for things correctly. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show how we're going to make it correct so that you can see in this one, you've got a thicker blue stroke, a thinner green stroke, and a thinner still white stroke. And this automatically applied black outline is following the original thickness. Relatively. This is really good little technique. Okay, I'm going to recreate this on the new map. And if you were present in last week's seminar, you will see that we applied it by going to target this overall roads layer using the meatball on the in the layers panel. And within that targeted layer, we created a new stroke which we dragged below the contents layer. If you can't understand this at this stage, please look at the recording from last week's webinar. But the technique was quite simple, and the lovely thing about the technique is that it is completely dynamic. So if I adjust the course of this road, that black stroke follows it. So far, so good. But what I want to do now is introduce another thinner road. And for that, I'm going to add another layer to this stack of roads here, and I'm going to call it B roads, which is the name or the reference system we use in the UK. And in the B roads, I'm going to select it, that layer, because I want to draw on it. I've already got a white stroke enabled here and no fill, and I'm simply going to add another road here. Now, we covered this last week, but I'm going to do this again, and I'm going to give this a 0.5 stroke width. And you can see how the problem is compounded here. So I'm going to draw another path like this, to connect the roads together. Now we see the lovely dynamic black lines being automatically generated. That's great, but we also see the problem of the different line thicknesses not being catered for. So let's see how we overcome that. I'm going to have to go to the layers panel again, because this is where all the automatic structuring of effects takes place, really, for this sort of method. And I'm going to create a new sublayer. At the moment, it isn't a sublayer. It's just been created as a new one above roads. But I'm going to call it outline path. And that's giving the game away of what we're about to do. And I'm going to drag that one into the roads layer system here. Now, I'm going to select the three road systems that I have in their individual layers again, and drag them into this new outline one. So what I'm effectively doing is creating a structure. If I make this panel a bit wider, you can see it even more clearly, of roads, a sublayer of outline path, and a sublayers or three sublayers of the motorways, A roads, B roads. Now, here comes the magic. I'm going to meatball the outline path layer here. And I'm then going to go to the effect menu, path, outline, well, stroke, let's call it that. Outline stroke, I should have called it, really. And you see everything suddenly jumps a little bit wider. That's fine. Let's go back now to the roads layer. I'm targeting it with the meatball again. And I can now reduce the thickness of the stroke. And suddenly, hey presto, we have a fantastic automatic road rendering system here that's taken into account the variable widths that are going on here. So you can see the thinner lines that are taking place on the small A roads have only got a nominal 1 point width around the edge of it, but there's only a 1 point width around the thicker green ones and the thicker again blue roads or motorways. And this mechanism works beautifully for creating maps. So if you want an even more elegant map system so that it creates these perfect results, add this additional layer. Now I call it outline path. It doesn't matter what you call it. You should actually perhaps call it outline stroke to make it technically correct, like so. And then apply with a meatballed or a targeted layer an outline stroke to that layer. It has nothing else in that layer. The only purpose of that layer is to have this outline stroke going on. Okay, now I just would like to ask, if you're watching a recorded version of this, this is a live recording, and at times in the live recordings, I'm going to ask if there are any questions, and my colleague Dave is here ready to field any questions you have, and he'll bat some answers or questions over to me, and I'll help do that. So please don't hesitate to put in the live chat any questions you have from what I've done so far, because from this point onwards, I'm probably not going to put this section as a recording on the YouTube afterwards. This is a bonus section at the end for anybody who is live now. And it's great to see Marianne. Hi, great. Hi to see you from Serbia. So great to see you online. And MF Paley. I don't know how you pronounce your tag name, but great to see you online as well. So let's go and zoom out of this road system a bit. And actually, I'll change over to this document here because I think I've set up. And I've created a new artboard here, which I'm going to zoom into and use this as a basis for drawing. Okay. It is Shift Command H on the Mac to hide artboards. I personally do not like seeing artboards. They really, really annoy me, but don't worry about that. I'm going to go to the Dynamic Shapes tool. And Dynamic Shapes is one of our plugins. It's called the VectorScribe plugin, and it's one of the tools in there. And in this, I can create a dynamic shape, as the name would suggest. Now, I'm here to actually say where the limitations of this outline stroke thing is going on. Now, if you just missed it, because I just see there's quite a few people who just joined us, I'm going to put the previous bit of the recording onto YouTube probably the next 24 hours. But I would just want to go through an issue we have with these sort of uniform strokes. And that is when it comes to dash patterns. A dash pattern, in my mind anyway, still consists of a uniform stroke because the dash itself is uniform. So let's make this a thicker dash, or a bit too thick there. Let's go there. And this is a trick that, again, some of you may or may not know. I'd love to hear, if you're online, please give a shout out. And Dave Mayfield, some of these questions here. Do you know this trick? If you want a series of dots around an arc, in this case a circle, how do you do that? Now, some people would use the transform, create circles, transform. There's a much better way, I find. And that's if I click on the stroke here, the button in the control panel at the top, or go to the stroke menu, whichever way you want to do it. I'm going to click on a rounded corner and a rounded cap. It's the rounded cap that's the most important one. And then I'm going to click on dashed line. And you'll notice I've got this right-hand option here, which is aligns the dash to the path. This is quite an important thing. It's a fantastic feature that Illustrator put in. And it's a very simple idea, but it really is good. Now, with a standard dash like that, what's happening? You're having a dash length of 12 points, then there's an automatic gap of 12 points, and a dash of 12 points, etc. But because I have got... Hey, that's the phone off the office in the background. Remind me to turn that off in the future. Because I have got rounded caps going on, it looks like they're closer together. It looks like these sausages are almost touching here. Well, really, it's the cap, the line of dash is ending around here, around the center point of the round cap, and then this sort of round cap is extending that dash a little bit further. So that's why they look like they're nearly touching, but the gap and the dash are the same. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to put a 0 point dash, which sounds really strange, but look what happens. When I put in a gap now of 15 points. Instant dots, round dots, that are following the path. There's none of this transform stuff going on, drawing a circle and then transform, repeating, etc. Now, a lot of you may be fully aware of this, you know, congratulations, you know, thank you. But some of you, I've noticed, have never seen this technique before, creating these lovely sort of dashes. And the thing is, it follows any path you like. So if I go to the dynamic shapes tool again, which I've got a shortcut for the S key, but you just click on the icon down here if you've got VectorScribe installed. Because it's a dynamic shape, I can change the shape to anything I like. So let's change it to a gear, a dynamic gear here. And I'm going to go out on the flyout menu, and I'm going to, convert it to a basic shape, I think we'll on this one. Let's see what happens. Now this looks like it makes absolutely no sense. So what we're going to do, go back to stroke, and I'm going to take the weight down to say 3 points, and I'm going to take the gap down to say 5 points. Actually, let's take the gap down one more point. And suddenly, you'll see what's happening. The dynamic gear, which is, you know, you can see a profile of a gear now, if I get rid of the dynamic shapes window like this, is being completely followed by this dash pattern. So I'd love to hear in a shout out, have you come across this before? Is this a technique that you've seen before? Is it a technique that you employ when you're creating artwork? It can be used for many, many sort of circumstances. But the reason I wanted to actually show this in this case is that if I undo and go back to here, if I employ the same technique as I did with the roads by creating a layer and applying an offset, etc., it doesn't quite work the same, sadly. I really thought that the live effect version could be used in the same way for this, to sort of outline a stroke, etc. But for some reason, Illustrator's internals, even though very, very powerful, it's the most powerful vector program of its type like this, it isn't catering for it fully. So what we're going to do, we're simply going to go to the appearance panel here. And if I want to create an outline around this, I'm going to drag the stroke down to the new icon down at the bottom of the appearance panel, like that. And you've got a duplicate of that stroke. From there, I can create, say, a red stroke, and as it's behind the other one, I'm going to increase the width of the stroke. And so you can see how this is creating a dynamic duplicate or an outline off the original dot pattern like that. The trouble with this one, it isn't as live as I'd like it. So if I go and change the top stroke, if I change the dash to say a square dash like this or a butt cap like that, it doesn't follow it. You'd have to sort of recreate that in the second stroke or delete the second stroke and start again. So in that respect, bit of a pity, but to be honest, better than nothing. So if I now go to say window, I'm going to go down to VectorScribe, and I'm going to go to the PathScribe panel like this. I can select all the handles in one go using PathScribe. Say I turn it inside out like that, You can see that the dash pattern is following that as well. It creates a sort of strange effect, but it's quite an interesting one. So let me look over at the live chat session. So Cinder, I've used that technique, but haven't used it with a VectorScribe plugin. I look forward to exploring more. Thank you, Cinder. So thanks for that feedback. I'd like to hear from anybody else. Was that of any use whatsoever? Please put it on the chat. This session is not going on the recorded bit. So if you want to ask about anything else with regards to our plugins, this is your time. This is basically, you got access to myself and Dave here. Dave, who's answering the questions kindly remotely, just ask away. We'd love to hear where your workflow issues are with native Illustrator, with perhaps our tools. So thank you, Sue, for liking the recording. Thank you very much. We'll make that public, just like we did last time. We'll put it on live. So please, if you've got any questions, if there are any issues you've got with your Illustrator workflow today, we can answer it. So we'll be here for a couple more minutes. And like I say, this part has not been recorded. So if it's anything confidential, let us know and we won't show it live. But if we can show it to everybody else to benefit them, that'd be fantastic. So, okay, so this is the... I'll tell you what, let me show some of the tricks perhaps with our tools while I'm waiting. So Dave will put in the questions over to me while I'm just doing tricks with tools. I'll be a tool monkey here to do this. And I don't know, a quick shout out, who has got VectorScribe? Because I can quickly show some nice tricks with that. Hang on, there's a question here from Bob. I think you can just select the second path in the appearance window and edit it as you did on the first one. Yes, Bob, yep, absolutely. Going back to this artwork here, if I undo that, if I change the top one, the top stroke, and if I edit that, so if I make that book up like that, I could do exactly the same to the second stroke down as well. Let me do that here. So book camp as well. So there you go. So yes, absolutely, Bob. No problem whatsoever. So Sue says, oh yeah, okay, tool tricks. Okay, give us a shout out. I'm going to do some tool tricks. I'll do some performing tricks, if you like. Think of me as your performing monkey for this. That's no problem. But give us some indications about where you would like to go, what sort of artwork you do. I'm just doing this live. This is, like I say, it's a test for YouTube as well. This is our YouTube live testing. So Cinder says, I've used PathScribe recently and it helped a lot. I was having trouble manipulating multiple handles of anchor points at once. Yeah, that's what I just showed. So, okay, Cinder, let's have a look at this. I've got a keyboard shortcut for dynamic shapes. So all I do is hit the S key and it comes up with dynamic shapes. If you want to know how you do that, you simply go to the edit menu in Illustrator, keyboard shortcuts, and here you can see I've got my own set called Nick. I am called Nick, that's why I called it Nick. I'm really intelligent like that. And I went to, I was correct there. I was in the tools drop down menu at the top, and I can select any tool that's present within Adobe Illustrator, including our plugins. And you can see here, for example, I've got dynamic shape set to S, corner set to C, PathScribe set to D, etc., 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 etc. You can guess how I'm going this. So I've got my own unique set. Now, if you're already using those keys for something else, yeah, don't use them. But I personally use them. Okay, let's go to PathScribe. Let's first draw a shape out, and I'm going to draw... I'll tell you what, let's draw a gear wheel. Let's not do it that way. Let's go to here. This is a fantastic thing. If you use if you use VectorScribe and you've got dynamic shapes in version 3, loaded up obviously, you can open the panel. If you haven't got the panel, just click on the dynamic shapes tool and it will load up the panel by default. Go out to the flyout menu and create a standard spur gear. Now, I'm gonna confess, we've got hundreds of functions in our plugins. This is the only one that I wanted to see for 10 years. And for 10 years, I asked my old longstanding colleague who created this very kindly for me, just to humor me, I think, and it's very good of him. I said, look, I want proper gears in Illustrator because I'm fed up of people drawing cartwheels and saying that's a gear. It's not a gear. So I said, can you draw a gear? So I went to flyout menu in dynamic shapes, create a standard spur gear with 8 teeth. Let's zoom in. Beautiful gear. Right, engineering gear. I'll do this. Create another dynamic gear. Keep the circuit pitch the same. And go over to, say, 20 teeth. Click on that. I'm going to get rid of the fill. Change it. Get rid of the fill like that. And hey, presto, you have two gears which will truly look like they mesh. Let's go into here. Now I can use ColliderScribe to mesh them in properly. Okay, what the heck, why not? Let's do this. Let's make this happen. There you go. I want it to mesh on that side. Gears don't normally mesh on two sides at once. Let's mesh it on that side. Okay, I could go in a bit further and mesh it a little bit better. Let's have a look. So let's go to Snap to Collisions. Now, I'm not taking any notice off the comments at the moment, which is really bad of me. Mesh it in a little bit further. Like I say, the gears aren't meant to mesh on both sides. So let's do it there. I'll stop faffing around, and there you go. Okay, let's go out. There you go, two beautifully meshed gears. Aren't they absolutely perfectly meshed? So next time you draw a gear for a client, please don't draw a cartwheel. Please do not do that. Draw proper gear like that. Okay, so the question was, now that I've done that, I'm going to delete it. What can you do with multiple handles? This is a thing in Adobe Illustrator. If you're in the, native tools, you cannot select more than one handle at once, even though you can show all the handles at once. I'll go back to that. And if I go to set the shape, you can go to, I believe it is preference. I haven't done this for a long time, so let's see. If I go to here and show anchor points and selection tool and same shape, you can do this. You can show handles here when multiple anchor points are selected. This is what I was looking for. In preferences, this one down here, show handles when multiple anchor points are selected. Click on that, and if I go there you go. Well, Illustrator isn't basically very good at doing this. It's showing the two handles here, but there's no way I can manipulate this one and that one at the same time. Impossible in Illustrator. So let's go back to the PathScribe tool. I'll just close that one off. PathScribe tool down here in the toolbox, part of VectorScribe. I see there's a question in the thing, so we'll come back to that. Thanks, Dave. Thanks for echoing that question out. And I'll come back to it in a second. I'll just, in the PathScribe panel, select this one. I love this one. Show all handles and select them at the same time on the path. And suddenly you see all the handles are selected. And I can do anything I like with that selection at the moment. So I can go crazy with a gear wheel. Makes no kind of sense. I can, if I click anywhere else, it deselects them. I can turn everything into a smooth point. Retract handles. Smooth point. Hang on, let me just do that. Retract handles. Smooth them out so you get something even weirder. It's a great way to start a concept. And let's take them out like that. You just create weird, weird patterns. Absolutely lovely way. I say call it the doily tool. Okay, let's go back to the questions. Otherwise, I'm going to lose you all here because I'm just starting to mess around here, aren't I? So, quick question. So, can I set the PathScribe tool, so select arrow, that so that once I use the arrow keys on the keyboard, only the selected anchor point moves, like with the default Illustrator white arrow? Okay. So, question here, and it is from Marconi. I repeat that. Can I set PathScribe tool so that once I use the arrows on the keyboard, only selected anchor points move? You know, that's a very, very good question. Let's go back. Let's come back to here. Let's undo one more time. And let's do that. Okay. So, PathScribe tool. PathScribe is very, very configurable, but if I do this, you'll see it is, if I use the arrow keys now, the actual anchor points are moving with the arrow keys. Now, if you're thinking, well, that's quite a big move, let's go down to Direct Prefs. If you haven't got Direct Prefs, download our installer. Dave, if you could please put the download link on our installer. Download our installer and give this a whirl. It is absolutely free. So let me see, Direct Prefs. Let me do that again, like so. Open the Direct Prefs panel. And this will appear in your life, this Direct Prefs panel. And Direct Prefs is fantastic. If I want to change how much these anchor points are moving, like this, if I'm using the left, right, top, bottom arrow keys, etc., I go to the keyboard increment here, and I've got it for some reason at 4.2333 millimeters. click on the 1mm button, and I can see adjust it around much more finely. If I click on where it says 1mm, I can set anything I like, say 0.1mm. So suddenly, if you all see that, I can do much finer adjustments like that, and it's really, really quick. If I want to set it back to 1mm, I just click on that, click it to 5mm, huge change, etc. So I hope that answers the question, can I do it? Yes, yes, in PathScribe I can. And let me just undo it until I get back to what I wanted. And hit the Enter key when I'm in the PathScribe tool, and you'll be able to see all the preference on basically how I can make PathScribe perform as I want. There's loads of things. There's self-explanatory. If you hover over questions as well, it'll give you some extra tool tips there as well. And don't worry if you're modifying this like crazy. You can literally, I'm on a small screen here, so this is not going to work. You can literally go to the menu and you can go back to default settings or better handles. I've got as a default one as well. So you can do it as you like there. So don't be afraid of modifying those preferences. Now I'm rattling on because this part is not being recorded and will not be present on the recording in YouTube afterwards. So I'm just going to check the messages, and mine is set so the whole path is moving, says Marconi. Maybe I've done something wrong with the settings. Yeah, Marconi, please go to the settings, have a look through there, and yes, it's likely you'll be able to adjust it so it moves everything as well. So, and Gradient Hero, who's online, says, finally proper gears. Thank you, Gradient. I appreciate that. Okay, let's see where else we're going to go with this. Now, please, if you want to have any questions answered, put them on the live chat session, and Dave will be more than happy to sort of prompt me while I look at one way or another. So I will perhaps have a look at one more thing, because Marconi was asking about the PathScribe preferences here. Not dynamic sketch preferences, that's my fault. So if I go to PathScribe, go to the preferences here, and you see there are quite a few options down here. Now, there's one which I find really funny, which is the smoothing ratio one, which is a very strange one. You find that there's a sort of a center point type thing, which isn't at the center. I'm going to just show this very, very quickly. This is just fun. Well, it is fun for me. So let me leave it as the default one, which is over there. So I'm going to delete everything here. I'm going to draw a basic circle. Now, I'm whizzing through the different sort of dynamic shapes I can do using the keys 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 0. I can change the different shape primitives very, very quickly whilst holding the mouse down. And I'm going to hit the 2, number 2, which is a circle. B for a basic circle. Hold down the shift. I'm holding the mouse down all the time. Hold down the shift key. Create a basic circle at 90 degrees. Let go. I've got a basic circle. Okay, that's a simple thing. Now, if I go to the PathScribe tool, again, I'm going to select it on the tool box down here. So this PathScribe tool here, part of VectorScribe plugin, available from Adobe Illustrator, etc. I'm going to retract the handles like that. Retracting the handles is a very basic concept in Adobe Illustrator. And basically, every single path segment within Illustrator is a Bezier curve, which sounds very strange because you think, oh, no, actually, that's not true. These are straight lines. If I just select it with the standard select tool, you think these are just straight lines with 4 points. Well, it was a surprise to me when I was working with our engineers years, years ago that they said, one of them especially said, no, actually, that's not true. That's actually a Bezier curve. It just happens to be that the Bezier handles are retracted over the actual anchor points. And because they've retracted all the other anchor points, they can't really steer the curve. So it isn't a curve, so it's a straight line. And my mind took months to get over this thing. If I go to the PathScribe tool with these points selected, you'll see that these ghost handles here allow me to quickly drag something out. Now, these ghost handles aren't actually there. If I just drag one out, you see it's now a genuine handle. If I drag that handle over the original anchor point, that's effectively retracting the handles, so making sure that is a straight line again. Now, do tell me on the live chat if I'm boring the heck out of you. These are really technical, nerdy things, and I can see the drop-off rate will go like crazy if I keep on talking, although not yet. So this was the whole point of retracting handles. This button here in the PathScribe panel, If you haven't seen it, don't see the PathScribe panel, ensure you've got VectorScribe version 3 loaded. Click on this in the toolbox, PathScribe tool, and then you can click on the retract handles, and that's what it is. Now, once I've retracted the handles, I can click on this button up here, which is Smooth Point. The interesting thing about this is that when I clicked on Smooth Point, it's created this perfect circle again. Absolutely like it was. Now, PathScribe wasn't remembering that this was a circle that's been turned into a square, and then, therefore, if you want to turn it back to a circle, it wasn't remembering that. What it was doing was, if I show all the handles, just moving the handles out so that they happen to correlate to a perfect circle. Now, this works for 4 points on a circle, on a square, and it can turn it into a circle like this. It's a very simple cheat. But if I go back to the, if I undo that, go back to the PathScribe preferences, if I get the right tool, let's go back. If I go to PathScribe preferences, if I now drag this smoothing ratio down to the minimum and click on OK, and then click on smoothing, it creates this wonderfully sort of slightly rounded square, which happens to be at 45 degrees. But you see how it smoothed it differently. So, Sue, thanks for posting that. You love that. Okay, I'd like to know whether this is sort of warranted or not. But you see how the smoothing has changed. If I undo that, I'm still in the PathScribe tool. Click on Enter again. Go back to the most smoothing. Click on this button again. You see now it's over-smoothed it. So it's beyond a circle. So different sort of results, which is quite a neat little trick, to be honest. And there are lots and lots of little tricks and tools within PathScribe, and I'll just run through a few of them that are my favorite. So if you've got PathScribe, this is the moment for you. Okay, let me go back to the preferences and put the ratio back to this line, and it sort of clicks to that line, so you know it's okay. I'll smooth it again, so back to a circle. Probably my favorite hidden key press in PathScribe, and it isn't hidden. We have now keyboard shortcuts. Dave is the guy who's answering this live chat. He very kindly created keyboard shortcuts that is available on our website. Now go to astutegraphics.com. You'll see all the new keyboard shortcuts in a PDF you can download and print. And I'm going to show one of my favorite ones in PathScribe. I'm going to click and drag on one of these segments. Okay, and doing that, I can reshape it. Now, Illustrator have kindly put that in as well. Thank you very much, Illustrator. That's very kind of you. But PathScribe could do this. Actually, other software could do this beforehand. It isn't us who's invented it. I'm not going to claim any glory. But you can move it around. I'm going to hold the mouse button down, or the trackpad button down. And whilst it's held down in the PathScribe tool, I'm going to hit the R key. R for retract handles. I'm not going to move the mouse while I've hit the R key, and then let go. I have turned that curve segment into a straight segment without affecting everything else. How many times have you wanted to change a curve segment into a straight segment? For me, it was the most frustrating thing. I can do it very easy the way around. I can just drag something out. There you go. If I put on Smart Smooth, I can make sure that this is nicely aligned, these handles. Okay, great. In fact, they're so nicely aligned, they're in fact automatically smart smooth. They are smooth points now. But how many times have you wanted to actually just retract a curve into a straight line? There you go. Thanks, Pelle. Thank you very much for saying you like that. That's great to see. Okay, let's continue with this. And one of my other favorite ones, I'm going to delete this segment. I'm just going to go to the direct select tool, click somewhere else, click back on that straight segment, hit the delete key. That's all I did. Let's undo that and see that again. So, go to the direct select tool. That's the A key, a shortcut. So, a native tool. Click somewhere else to deselect. Click on the straight segments portion and hit the backspace or delete key. Deletes it. Okay, that was simple, wasn't it? Let's go back to the PathScribe tool. And let's look at these handles. Now, I'm going to move one of these handles. So they are more obscure. There we go. Now, if I want to change the trajectory of these handles, it's very easy. I can move it around. If I want to extend the length of a handle, obviously, I click and drag it around. Great. But typically, what you want to do is also try and retain the angle off that handle. Now, in PathScribe, I'm going to click on it, hold down the Option key, the ALT, the Alt, I can never say out, I always say out, I don't know, like out the front door, but the Alt key, the Option key on the Mac, and corresponding on Windows, hold it down, click and drag as you like, crazy, and it will keep that angle. Hallelujah. Yep, keeps the angle, doesn't start annoying everything. Right, brilliant. So I can do that on this one as well. So this one here, it's even worse when you start affecting the angle of the handle on the opposite side on a smooth point. Hold the Option key down. There you go. Keeps that handle at the same angle, which is really hard to say, which is why I slowed down there. Okay, everybody okay with that? Everybody seen that? Useful little tips? Where would Illustrator be without Astute Graphics? You could say that better the other way around. Where would Astute Graphics be without Adobe Illustrator? But thank you very much. I know where you're coming from. Sue says, please record these non-record bits. Pure gold. No, Sue, these are for you. You've made the effort to stay online. These are purely for you. I'm just going to chop the rest of this up. This is me yapping away. So we could do it live. We'll see. Okay, let's go somewhere else with this. Here's the thing. If you are in the PathScribe tool and you don't see this lower section of the tool, it's because you have not got the hide numeric values ticked. So I'm going to tick that. And you see that is a bit hidden now. It now says show numeric values. So if yours says show numeric value fields, click on that and you'll see the numeric values for these handles. If you want that handle to be in a specific angle, this is so hard to say. You can see it down here. I want a 45 degree angle. There you go. I want a 135 degree angle. There you go, etc. Minus 45 degrees. And I can control it really, really precisely. You also see down at the bottom, you can click through the points in the handle. You think, why would you want to do that? Why would you want to cycle through the points in a path? Okay, let me show you. I'm going to go and create a circle again. I'm that imaginative. I'm then going to put on a brush. There you go, a brush. Now, this brush, native brush, nothing special. Don't get excited. This native brush starts at 12 o'clock. You can see where it sort of tapers out to nothingness, and then it's all sort of all there again. So you can see where it starts. That is lovely. That is really, really nice of it, etc. I didn't necessarily want that brush to start there, and in Illustrator, I've got no control over that. And you go, haha, yeah, no problem. All you do is rotate it. I would say, yeah, okay, very, very clever. Rotate that. Very smart. The trouble is, this is now a heart shape. Rotate it, you cannot do. Okay, so let me get this heart. Oh, let me see. Let's change the heart parameter for that. There you go. Do I like this heart shape? Let's extend it up a bit. There you go. Dynamic heart. There's another way to adjust it. Let's go back to it. Okay, dynamic heart shape. And you go, okay, very clever, but I wanted now the point to start here. You can't just rotate it. So what you do, let's go to the PathScribe tool again, and I've got the letter D for that keyboard shortcut again. I'm going to click on this point here and say I want it to start at that point. I could cycle through the points, and you can do that, but I can equally click on it. But I want the brush to start on the 3 o'clock position point. PathScribe panel open, fly up menu, start path at selected point. And instantly, that brush has moved to start at that point. That's really neat, that is. That's good. But say I wanted to actually move that point around a bit as well. And let's click on here. I'm going to click and hold down in VectorScribe version 3 on the PathScribe tool, and I've got Reposition Point Tool. Now, if I have this point selected, which I do, I can literally just move it around. This is black magic. Okay, this is absolute magic to people. I can move this point around, so I can start this point wherever I want. Now, you'll notice if I go too extreme, it can't quite keep to that shape. It's having a really good attempt. I'm moving the point. I'm not adding a point. I'm moving that point around. I'm going to move it down to here. And with that point moved down to there, I'm going to go back to PathScribe. Start point. Start path at selected point. There you go. It has actually moved that around there. We're getting some great feedback. Thanks, Sue. You keep on saying nice things. Appreciated. And Bob could not live without Astute. Oh, Bob, you say the nicest things. Thank you. Okay, any questions, you know, please post them. I'm going to have to call it time very soon because we have actually got a meeting to go to in quarter of an hour. This was not intended. 3/4 an hour. I think Dave might be on Valium or something like to keep him awake at this point. Apologies, Dave. We are going to get offline fairly soon. I know we've got some other things to do. But if this is the sort of thing you like seeing, please let us know. We need to have feedback from you. What your problems are with your workflow, native Illustrator workflow, Astute Graphics plugins. What are your problems? We want to know them. This will help us make future sessions. Okay, so I'm going to demand that everybody who is online now, and if you're watching somewhere else, go back to that keyboard in front of you and type in your worst thing in Adobe Illustrator, things that you really do not like. And yes, you can say things about Astute Graphics plugins as well. I need to know from every single one present, and there's 31 of you present, what is your least favorite thing in Adobe Illustrator? That is all I'm going to ask for in return for this time that you've had with us. So please, stick it on. And Dave has also correctly said, also sent a hello at astutegraphics.com, Dave.com. Hello at astutegraphics.com. Not the UK. We are a British company, but it's not. Sorry, Dave. Pick you up on that one. Hello at astutegraphics.com. So please, put it in that live chat session now. I want to see what your biggest fear with Adobe Illustrator now is, your worst thing off Adobe Illustrator, what you're having most trouble with, which tool you're having most trouble with, etc. Cheers, Dave. It's hello at astutegraphics.com. Thumbs up there. So just enjoying the session, Pele. Please do more of these sessions. No worries, Pele. Pele, please stick in your worst nightmare with Illustrator as well. We want to hear what this is. This is the only way we're going to make it a long-running thing. We need to have some interaction and some feedback. So go to the live chat session in YouTube. If you haven't got access to the live chat, if you're not logged in, I presume it won't let you. Send it to hello at astutegraphics.com. I'm going to bully you all until you write something down. So Marianne, thank you very much. You recommend all Astute Graphics plugins. You are very kind. So Dave has just written as well that worst thing in Illustrator. What is it? Come on, Will. And then we're going to have a quick think about what we're doing on Thursday when the next truly planned session is going to be. And it should be at, we think, Dave, correct me if I'm wrong, it probably will be 9 p.m. UK time, which is, doing quick maths again, 1 p.m. in Pacific Standard Time, and it is 4 p.m. at Eastern Standard Time, so West and East Coast of America, respectively. Okay, Irvin, it's good to see you online. Worst thing for me is the way Pathfinder takes care of creating anchor points. The worst thing for me is the way Pathfinder takes care of... Oh, sorry, I see what you mean. Yes, okay. Too many anchor points, where it's putting them. Yes, okay, so better anchor point placement. Sorry, Irvin, I was being very slow there. Yep. I want your Boolean technology. Oh, I can't show that because this is... Well, it is still technically being recorded. I was going to chop the last bit off, to be honest, the last half an hour of yapping out off, but... The Boolean technology, Irvin, if you... Yeah. Now, Dave, I wonder if you can put in astutegraphics.com/tech. If anybody doesn't have a clue what Irvin is talking about with the Astute Graphics technology, have a look at astutegraphics.com/tech. So that's another one to have a look at. So moving points around in your plugin solves that. Yeah, so yeah, it does. There's other tricks for moving points to tangencies. That's in the PathScribe tool. We've put in version 3, a really obvious one here. Move points to tangencies. Lovely trick. Doesn't have to be 90 degrees. Would love to see anybody's comments, please, in live chat. I am going to bully you until you all do a comment in live chat. What is your worst thing? So Irvin's kindly put in something there. Point placement, basically, after Pathfind operations, native Pathfind operations. Please put in your worst point about native Adobe Illustrator or with our plugins installed as well. What are you having trouble with? So So Marianne, thank you, Marianne. Probably worst thing, joining shapes and path offsets. Path offset, that's a great one. Okay. I'm going to show this while you're all thinking about what to write, because you are all thinking about what to write. Your worst things in Adobe Illustrator. And Dave, we're going to be offline soon. So your last chance. Let me see if I cycle through. Let's go back to a cloud. There we go. I'm starting to sing to myself. That's really bad. Okay, offset. If you haven't got this tool from Adobe Illustrator, from Astute Graphics, Stylism. Stylism panel. It's native in Illustrator. We just make it really nice to work with. Stylism is a full plugin for Adobe Illustrator, obviously. Click on the offset, and you're offsetting it by the length of the stick. Trick, if you have a Stylism installed in Adobe Illustrator, and you're thinking, that's a very nice stick, but it's really, really not intuitive. It's not relating to any point. That's because we don't know which point to relate it to, you know, without reading your mind. We haven't got that technology yet. Hold down the Option key, the Alt key, the one next to Command, okay, on Mac. And then click and drag on the, effectively, the left-hand end of this stroke here. And it clicks to any point. You're not seeing this yet? Utterly brilliant. Clicks to the point. And now I can offset in relation to that point. And hey presto, it's really intuitive. And you can see in the Appearance panel, there's the native offset. It's been put there. It's just that we can allow you to control it really, really dynamically. So if you haven't seen that yet, there's a little tip for you. So again, if you go out the tool, go back to it, you will lose that position. It doesn't stick with it. Option key, click on the end of that sort of lollipop and drag it to a point or anywhere along the path. That also works as well. And you can control the offset intuitively. Really, really intuitive. There you go. Okay, tip of the day. Right, we're going to have to close shop now. We're off. Much to do, much food to eat, much drink and merriment to be made. Or in other words, known as another meeting. So, lovely to have you all here. And, okay, Sue, you'd love to have these short, quick video tips, all your plugins. Okay, quick question to everybody, yes or no answer, because we've had only a few suggestions of what you'd like to see. Would you like to see rambling chats like this in the future? So quick yes or no, and then we're going to close shop. So thank you very much. Yep, lots of videos on the YouTube channel. Dave says thank you, Dave. So it's youtube.com/astutegraphics, but you're probably here already. Yes, thank you. Jesse, apologies, I'm going to end the Spanish one. Would like to see it. Marion, yes. Sue, yes. Ron, yes. Irving, yes. Bob, yes. You'd like to see tips. Just thanks, Dave. Yeah, thank you, Dave. Thank you, Dave, for doing this as well. Thank you from Sue. So anybody else would like to see rambling tips like this? If you want to see rambling tips, just give us a shout and we can literally do rambling sessions. So we could have the Merry Illustrator Rambler, and we need a graphic for that. We need an Illustrator Rambler. Don't know if the word rambler translates to other languages. Somebody who walks across the fields with a backpack and a big stick and climbs over fences and tells farmers that it's their right of way. So that's what a rambler is. I aspire to be one. There you go. Wee wee, says Luna. Thank you very much. James Chang. Okay, you'd all like to see rambling chats. Great. Nobody said no. Get off the screen now. Cool. Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody, for attending. Like I say, elements of this will be available on, especially the beginning of this, elements will be available on our YouTube channel. And Dave says, Rambler also eats Kendall mint cake. Very true, Dave. Thank you for pointing that out. That was very true. And hopefully we'll see you on Thursday. Remember, 9 p.m. UK time, 1 p.m. Eastern Standard, Pacific Standard Time, 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Why can't we just all have 1 clock in the world? And there we go. Thank you very much. Appreciated. Thank you all for attending. And I wish you all a fantastic rest of your day. Thank you very much.